That bitter benchmark in the tropical disaster in Mexico. The death toll from landslides triggered by once Hurricane Manuel topped 100.
Yeah, rescuers are still digging through tons of mud and debris in remote Mexican villages. The search crews are using shovels and even heavy machinery to sift through the rubble in hopes of finding survivors.
For the latest on what's happening now in the tropics, let's check in with storm tracker Jim Cantore. He's live in the Global Forecast Center. Jim?
Yeah, and I think it's interesting to kind of go back and look at Manuel because it kind of snuck up on us as a tropical storm two Fridays ago, then made its way on shore, and then eventually was a tropical storm once again, and a hurricane in the Gulf of California. So kind of an amazing storm at that. And of course, we all remember seeing the pictures out of Acapulco. Now, remember, this is, again, two Fridays ago, all right, where we saw this thing happen. So remember, it's not just last Friday. So here it comes, pretty much offshore of Acapulco, then making its way up toward Manzanillo, weakening on shore, but then enough of an entity just coming in to the base of the Gulf of California where kaboom, it went tropical storm and hurricane once again and then made its way on shore. So tremendous rainfall obviously ensued. So here we are again, western Mexico. Here's Acapulco way down here. Here's the track in white. So here it is on shore, then back out over land, and then back on shore. So just a tremendous amount of rain. Not surprising it didn't produce a lot here because it was just weak. I mean, it was just a little entity left over, but then it blew up once it got the water over the water once again. But phenomenal amounts of rain. Now, remember, as that was all going on, we had Ingrid on the other side, one of the rare I-name storms in the Atlantic Basin, by the way, which probably won't be retired. But talk about a 1-2 punch for eastern Mexico and western Mexico. The mountains obviously fared a lot better. It was the lowland areas that got absolutely crushed. Then, if you remember on Thursday, once this was a hurricane again, so here we are a week later, now into Friday again, this thing came over Del Rio and across Texas with tremendous amounts of rain, especially for South Texas. I noticed that Lake Travis ticked up again because of the rainfall from this thing. In some cases, it actually had we saw a couple areas measured 7 inches, plus the water, the precipitable water. Remember, we're talking about that. What's the water vapor in the column of air sitting over Del Rio was very, very high, if not record-setting for the Del Rio area. So all that tropical moisture making its way on over through the Gulf of Mexico now and really helping to soak Florida with copious amounts of rain. Alex and Mark, back to you.
Thank you so much. Well, while this hurricane season has been a quiet one, it seems like the seasons in recent years have been very busy.
And while the overall numbers might have been higher, there still are a couple of surprises. Senior hurricane specialist Brian Norcross explains.
In spite of the slow hurricane season so far this year, it sure feels like we've had a lot of strong storms affecting the eastern part of the U.S. over the past 10 years or so. But maybe not. Take a look at this. The last Category 3 or above storm to hit the U.S. was Hurricane Wilma. It was October 24th, 2005, almost 8 years ago. And nowhere in the record books going back 100 years have we gone 8 years with no Category 3 above landfalls. And here's another statistic. If we just look at the eastern part of the U.S. and Florida, over the past 48 years, we've had 7 Category 3 and above storms hit. But if we go back 48 years before that, we had 25 Category 3 and above storms hit the east coast of the U.S. and Florida. So if you look on this measure, maybe hurricanes now aren't as strong, or certainly hurricane seasons haven't produced systems that have been as strong when they made landfall in the eastern part of the United States. It's a different way to look at it. Keep that in mind. All right, back to you.
Thank you so much. We are updating the heart-wrenching recovery in the Rockies after deadly flooding when Weather Center Live returns. Storm tracker Jim Cantore, he was on the front lines of the flood disaster. He's going to tell us some of the things that he'll never forget about that Colorado flooding coming up. Right now, we leave you with a look of sunset at Top of the Rock. This in New York City, just a little daylight left. The lights are on in the Big Apple. We'll have more on your forecast wherever you live coming up. Your Local on the 8s is next.